The farmers' mobilization campaign will kick off this month in the 5 districts in the Greater Mubende, including Mitiana, Kasanda, Chiboga and Chankwanzi, and later it will spread across the country. Speaking to the journalists today at her offices in Kampala, the Prime Minister of Uganda, Robin Nabanja, noted that they have mobilized a team of experts in the agriculture sector whom they are to move with to sensitize the farmers on the best farming methods, production, land protection, climate change, market, accessing agriculture loans, among others.
Yes. Under the umbrella of the office of the Prime Minister, move there together. And I believe if the Ministry of Agriculture is talking about production, and the Ministry of Lands is protecting the land for farmers to be safe on their land, the Ministry of Environment is talking about how to protect our environment, the Ministry of Disaster Preparedness is also giving them early warning signals, the Ministry of Local Government is talking about PDM.
Best practices of post-harvest handling and value addition are top on the list of techniques farmers will be equipped with.
When I was in my village, I found a farmer who was harvesting his maize before it dried. And I believe that is one of the reasons why we have aflatoxins in our maize. We are there. We are going there to tell our farmers and so that they can do better.
The State Minister of Agriculture, Fred Chakulaga, is optimistic that the campaign will boost the country's agriculture sector. He reiterated the call to embrace the commercial agriculture.
We shall use this platform created by the Right Honourable Prime Minister to further expound on the message of His Excellency the President, that we should, as leaders, convince, guide, facilitate, encourage, and teach Ugandans how to wake up.
The move by the Office of the Prime Minister to traverse the country sensitizing farmers follows the 6 policy guidelines to revamp agriculture, which were recently put out by the President in the effort to transform the country. The guidelines include production, disease control, agriculture mechanization and irrigation, farmer education and mobilization, partnership with big landowners, and intervention in the fisheries subsector. Story by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.